Hi everyone, in this tutorial we are going to cover how to create Spring JPA Couchbase application with Spring Boot. Okay, so before we start development we should know what is Couchbase database and when to use it and advantages over other NoSQL database. So first of all, Couchbase server is an open source distributed multi-model NoSQL document oriented database. So as it is open source, it is freely available for the developer and it is distributed so that we can share it across multiple nodes, multiple servers. So here it is multi-model so that we can keep the format on document base, graph base or binary base. Okay. So similarly, we have the one more document oriented database, that is MongoDB, but there is few disadvantages on MongoDB, so that Couchbase came into the picture. Okay, so now let's see what are the advantages over other NoSQL database. So this Couchbase database rapidly scalable to millions of users so that we can easily scale it. Data can be structured, semi-structured and unstructured. It support large number of concurrent users. Okay, data can be flexible, stored as JSON document or binary data, that's why it support the multi-model. No need to predefine data types, does not require extensive data modeling, data structure is of lesser significance during development. So we should not bother about the data modeling, we should focus on the development, as there we can keep both structured and unstructured data model. Okay, so this is just basic overview on Couchbase database. So if you want to work with this Couchbase, you need to download the Couchbase server. Let's go to the browser. This is the official Couchbase site where we can download the Couchbase server. So we are using 6.0, which is the latest release. So you just need to download it. Once you will download, if you want, you can customize your memory based on node index. You can customize, but if you don't want, just simply click on use the default memory. Okay, so once you installed it, it will be available on port 8091. So let's hit it, localhost 8091. Okay, and while install itself, you need to provide your credential. So I just gave the credential, Java tech key, and the password is password. Okay, let's sign in. Once you will sign in, there is a few features. This is the dashboard. You can configure your server, you can create the bucket. So how we are using document in MongoDB, similarly there is a concept, we can create the bucket. Bucket is similar to our database. We can say bucket can have contents multiple records in the structured and unstructured data format. Okay, so first let's create a bucket. There is a option, add bucket. Just give the bucket name. I am giving Java techie, and if you want, you can increase the memory size. I am using the default one. Now click on add bucket. If you want, you can customize your bucket. Okay, go to the edit, advanced bucket setting. So here, if you want, just click on flush enable so that unused data will be flushed in periodically manner. Click on auto compaction. Okay, if you want, then you can customize. Without customized also, the bucket will be stored the data. Okay, so let's click on save changes. This is our bucket with the name Java Tiki. Okay, so we did the installation and we created the bucket. Now let's quickly create a Spring Boot application to store data on this Couchbase server on our Java Tiki bucket. Okay, let's go to the Eclipse, create a Spring Boot project. Just name it like Spring Boot Couchbase example. Change the description here, Spring Boot with base and we are using spring data, right? So change the package name couchbase.api. Now click on next. Let's add the required dependency. Let's not use the latest one. Let's use 2.0.6. I'm going to add DevTools, going to add Wave, going to add Lombok. Now let's add the Couchbase. Couchbase comes under NoSQL, so we can use Couchbase and Reactive Couchbase. So as of now, let's use the Couchbase. Okay, now import this application. Application imported successfully. Now let's go to the application, create the required package. Okay, let's create model. Dot model. Similarly, create repository. Okay, so let's create the model class first. Create a class called customer. Okay, now let's add the required field. Let's add private int id, private string name. Let's add address, private string array address. Okay, as we added, we no need to write the getter setter manually. Let's use Lombok provided annotation. Add the red data. Okay, now add no argument constructor, and we want all argument constructor as well. Okay, so to make this as document, we need to annotate @document. If you observe, this document is imported from Spring Framework data Couchbase core. Okay, so similarly, to make this id as primary key, we need to add primary key @id annotation, and it belongs from Couchbase client Java repository. And to make this name and address as a field, we need to annotate @field annotation. Okay, @field. Now let's create the repository class. Create a repository called customer repository. It should be one interface so that we can extend it from Couchbase repository. Okay, now provide the document here. Our document name is customer, and give the data type of your primary key. We are using integer here. Okay, so we created the model, we created the repository. So from our Spring Boot application, to connect with Couchbase server, we need to add few of the property where we need to mention the host and our bucket name, password, and to create the auto index and view, we need to enable it. Okay, so let's go to the properties file. Let me add those properties. So as I told, we need to add the host, and the bucket name is our Java techie, and the password, and Spring Data Couchbase auto index true, so that it will create index and view in our Couchbase server. Okay, so to enable this index, let's go to the repository. Here we need to annotate n1q primary indexed, and we need to mention @view indexed. Okay, here we need to mention the design docs and the view name. Okay, so design docs is our customer, and we want to generate the view name for all. Okay, so now we are done with repository model, and from our Spring Boot application to Couchbase server connection. Okay, so if you are using the local host, you can specify the local host. I am using this port, so I mentioned this one. Okay, so now let's go to the class. Let's create a REST controller, annotate this one as REST controller, Now inject the repository here, customer repository, injecting using auto add. Okay, so let's add few of the record on this Couchbase server, then later we will fetch it from our REST controller. Okay, so let's write me one init method, public void init customer repo. Now use this repository dot save all method so that we can save list of record at single shot. Okay, let's import this statement, java util stream. I just add two object, new customer 1 and 2 with the address. Okay, now I want to save those data at the type of my application load. Okay, so for that let's annotate post construct. Now write one more method to fetch all the list of record, list of customer, get all, and return it from there. Is we should not keep the space, return from our repository dot find all. Okay, it should return iterable, I guess. Yep, just change the return type to iterable and annotate this one at the rate get mapping, specify the URL something like fetch all customers. Okay, so we added few document to our Couchbase server with the help of this post construct init approach, and at end we are fetching all the record which is available in our Couchbase server. Okay, so now let's run our application. If you observe, there is no documents, right? Item is 0. Okay, so once we'll run this application, Java application, the item count will be changed in our Couchbase server. Let's observe here. Let me zoom it. Okay, our application is open port 8080 and I have one get mapping method, so that URL mapped here. Okay, so if you go to the browser now, the item count is changed to 2. Okay, let's go to the documents, the two document, two object which we added is available here now, and this is also the JSON format. You can change the format if you want. You can go to the spreadsheet. Okay, you can check here, and you can check the analytic view as well. Let's go to the bucket again, check the statistic. You can find out based on hour, minute, day, week. Okay, and the summary. So this is just, they provided the simple UI to monitor your server, Couchbase server, with the populated data from our application. Okay, now let's hit this URL to check the document is available or not. Go to the localhost 8080. Okay, all the two record which is available in our Couchbase server, we are able to fetch it. Okay, yep, that's it about this particular video. Here we get to know the installation process of Couchbase server and when to use it and how we can integrate it with Spring Boot application. Okay, yep guys, if anyone have any doubt or concern, you can add a comment, and those who not subscribed yet, please go ahead and subscribe it, and thanks for watching this video.